Now, in Victoria, we've got Victorian taxpayer money being used for more government board appointments. This is to push diversity targets. But, Keith, I think here they're talking about the only diversity, you know, that they care about. They're not talking about viewpoint diversity. They're not trying to actually get the sort of diversity that matters on boards.
Rita, I'm all for the novel approach. How about we put people on boards who, A, know what they're doing, and, B, can actually provide something constructive? I don't care what their gender is or their background or anything else. I mean, you could have a board made up entirely of women if that's the best outcome for whatever the organisation is. What difference does it make? But fundamentally, this concept that the taxpayer is now going to fork out even more in Victoria, a state which we know is broke, which Dan Andrews has completely run into the ground, on the concept that, hey, we want some people from particular backgrounds, not necessarily ones which might be relevant to the role they have to play, whether they've got to meet the requirements of ASIC or any other corporate oversight, we just don't know. So I think if it just keeps going this way in this country, well, it's detrimental for the outcome. And the outcomes of most of these boards and organisations are about the people. That's what we're just talking about. I mean, this is why there's a referendum, because the people will decide and we should act in the people's interest.